Bonjour, but what do French women eat to stay so slim with all the heavy traditional French cuisine? Is it a myth or reality? You'll tell me. I will tell you now what I eat during a day and my eating habits. But if you want to know the three reasons why I think that French women can be slimmer than others, check out the video up there for more insights. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. I'm Giga, a French CEO expat, born in Brittany and raised in Lyon. After living in 7 different countries, I blog at Expat in France to help English-speaking expats to understand the French intricacies, mainly the red tape, but also the confusing French culture. If you haven't subscribed yet to my channel, you can click on the subscribe button below and the bell not to miss my next video. First, this video is not about being slim, or that people should be slim. It is about the French healthy eating habits. Feeling good in our body and being healthy is the most important. There are other diets, and I am a big fan of Asian diets too, and I love Brazilian cuisine. But now, let me share with you my eating routine. Let's start with breakfast. This is really my weak point. I'm not very consistent with breakfast, and I often skip it when I'm running late. I'm trying to change that now. And also, I've realized that my breakfast habits have changed a lot depending on where I live. Before, I was in Brazil and I had a very northeastern Brazilian breakfast with a tapioca crepe or couscous, all savory food with a tropical fresh fruit smoothie. As a foreigner living in France, are you having a French breakfast, a sweet breakfast, or do you keep your home country breakfast habits? In France, I am mainly having toast with butter and my mom's homemade jam with a black and dark coffee. No milk, no sugar. And when I have time, I would make myself a fresh seasonal fruit smoothie. But one important thing, when I say toast, I mean tartine with real bread. But not the industrial sliced bread, the pain de mie, with a lot of additives and sugar, but also no texture or taste. Also, I like having a chia seed mixed with coconut milk, fruits, almonds, and honey. This is not typically French. Actually, a German friend of mine shared her recipe with me, and I just love this. This is like an energy boost to start well the day. Then I'll have lunch at about 12:30 or 1. I am not a big carnivore, even though I like meat. I'd say that I'm a flexitarian if I need to give it a label. But I'll always have at least 2 vegetables during my meal, often much more. If I don't have during a meal, I would catch up for the next one. So as a starter, I'd have a salad with raw seasonal vegetable. It is important for me to have good quality products, and in my opinion, this is only possible with seasonal ones. Plus, it is better for the planet and the wallet. And I also like adding nuts, condiments, dry fruits to my food. In winter, I'd also crave homemade soup and gratin. Always homemade. And I usually make a big batch of soup that I freeze in portions for later. I like cooking, but not the whole deal every day. And also, I never, ever buy pre-prepared food at the supermarket. Or in very rare occasions. Like when I go to an apéro and I had no time to prepare homemade nibbles. Talking about the apéro, I will soon do a video about this very French or Southern European habit. You will find it up there, as usual. As a main course, I'd have veggies and carbs, and I also love pulses, like lentils or chickpeas, and it goes greatly with cereals, like couscous, quinoa or bulgur. Did you know that combining the two, cereals and pulses, actually gives protein? A tip that many vegetarians would know, I guess. That explains many traditional dishes when you think about it, right? Well, I'm straying from the point, my French diet. There is one thing I never cook, and I wish I did. It is fish. I've never learned to cook fish and seafood, and I love it. But I'm just not from the seaside, so I've never learned to cook it well. Also, I've never really eaten it at home as a child, so when I go to the restaurant, I usually have the fish option. And then the cheese, of course. I am a big cheese lover. This is the food I miss the most with a good fresh baguette when I am abroad. I don't have it at every meal. Almost and at least a bit. Mon péché mignon. My guilty pleasure. Then I usually end my meal with a fruit or yogurt with jam, but I don't buy already flavored yogurt. Also, I'd have yogurt only if I didn't have cheese before. My doctor warned me against eating too much dairy, and French people eat a lot of them. Have you seen the French supermarket, the yogurt section? My mom always said that everything is good, but in balanced portions. I'd say that this applies to homemade food and raw products. The rest is guilty pleasures. It's okay, I'm all about guilty pleasures, like a nice pastry or saucisson, as long as it remains an exception. One important thing, I don't eat anything until dinner, at 7 or 8 p.m. If I'm really hungry, I'd have a banana or nuts to make me wait until dinner time. I guess my parents repeated so much to me as a child, on ne mange pas entre les repas. We don't eat between meals, that it became natural. Well, it wasn't really as a teenager, I can't tell you that. Then, of course, the dinner time. At dinner, I usually have a lighter meal if I'm not eating out. No risk of that currently. So I'd have a soup or a salad with a toast of pâté or cheese or maybe tapenade. And I also like eating a quiche with a salad and then a fruit. I usually don't have the 3 or even 4 course meals as I do for lunch, with the starter, main, piece of cheese and a fruit as dessert. So what do you think? Let me know in the comments below, I'd love to know. Some of you might think, but how doesn't she crave crisps or chips or sodas, pastries, sweets? Of course I like having saucisson or crisps, but just sometimes. And why do you think French people organize apéro? And also, I don't like sodas. I'd have water with my food or wine. And I guess my eating habits come down to 3 things that, in my opinion, makes the whole difference when it comes to having a French diet. If you want to know more about it, check out the video up there where I explain everything in detail. That's it for this sneak peek into my plate. I hope you liked it. If you did, you can give this video a like and subscribe to the channel for more French insider tips. Thank you for watching. Merci et à bientôt.